Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches Director's Cut Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I'm cutting out a huge amount of stuff again, me wandering around kind of aimlessly. One thing I did miss. So I like started to figure some of this out, but then stopped because I'm like, I'm making progress, so now I should record this. It's not here. I can move up there. This hose needs to be attached even more. Right, attached to that. At least I think, because it lets me do it. I guess we're gonna... We're gonna water the tree. And pull the shovel out at the same time. I also want to take another look at that photograph. I mean, I have done so already, but we're gonna be nearby. Because now we can actually, well, sort of, get the water running. It's always this area that's hard to see through, okay? I'm glad it centers you again once you go through doors. This is actually a video you're watching, which is... It's very good the way they integrate that. Videos along with static images of the actual environment. I always like seeing things like that. You see it, believe it or not, in Oddworld's Abe's Odyssey. So when he moves from section to section and the little videos play. Is this where I want to be? This is the kitchen, right? Yes. Alright. Close to that accursed basement. Alright, let's take another look at this photo. We want to go digging up the body. Unfortunately, I wish I could just take these things with me, but he won't. Oh god, here we go again. Hold on. Okay, we completely... I was bumped down to windows again. It's... there. Okay, so this looks to be the side of the tower. This is on the way to the greenhouse, isn't it? Or on the way to the crypt, either one. I'm not gonna go looking there just yet, because we have to go down to the basement. Then we have to go up outside back to the greenhouse. Maybe then I'll take a look over there first. Just for the hell of it. Turning. Oh no! Bathroom. Didn't mean to go in here. Turning left is what I was about to say. Very slowly. I hate when all the music stops like that. It's like something's about to happen, right? Okay. So this is the water here. Try as I might, I couldn't move the valve with my bare hands. Well. Make Gordon Freeman proud. I retrieved the crowbar as it could be needed elsewhere. Wait. I didn't actually do anything. Okay, Gordon, don't be too proud yet. How do I work this? Obviously I want to turn the wheel. But all I'm doing is taking the crowbar back. Not what I'm intending. Can I... Oh. When we leave, it automatically goes back. Okay. This is as far as I got, in case you guys were not sure. This is as far as I got here. Wait. I'm like, aha, I can turn it. And it won't let me turn. Maybe you need to attach something else. Hammer it. Ah. There was no more need to fiddle with the valve. What about the drain cover? Since I'm here, should we try to open it? Do something with it? I think I tried some of these things already on it. We'll lube it up. I tried the hammer already. I'll hurt myself. Should we listen? Is there someone down there? Okay. The furnace. Oh my god. I can't believe you crawled through that thing. Uninteresting boxes. Door. Now, out here might be the way. Not here, right? You can see the tower from the photo. And the tower's not near here. I don't see that. See anything from like it from here. I mean, I'm pretty sure that's the tower. Okay. Gotta be around the front. You have to go that way anyway. But we'll be scoping out the place, this way we'll know where to dig. Maybe. Doors again. How many times have we opened and closed these doors? At least 10. Not this. Around the side of the tower, right? Oh, we've very rarely been out here, right? So where is she buried? Where did you bury her, James? We're looking for her. Tower is there. The soil in the area of the garden, in this area of the garden, was devoid of life. It's got to be here, mister. Especially because this is an interactable thing. I know, we need the shovel. Just trying. Just for the hell of it. Not useful. Pointless. I know. I'll hammer her corpse to bits. Alright, let's go. Am I headed the right way? Yes. Mysterious, shiny object. Will the water be running now, I wonder? The object is still there. The water has not run. But it's not attached to anything. Is it? It's attached to this. But I don't know really what we accomplished by doing that. Is there something else? Oh god, not again. Whee! China, hold up. I'm trying to regain control. I can't. I'm stuck. Sorry about that, guys. What am I missing? Do I have to snip it again? Oh. Do I have to block more? I mean, unblock more? Maybe over here this blocks this part of the drain as well, and I just didn't notice. I mean, we're obviously trying to flush whatever that is out. Did I not turn it right? Maybe I have to go back. I mean, I turned it. Maybe I have to keep turning it. But it just turns back the other way. Me fiddling with it, I don't think changed anything, but can we check to see if the water is running here? The water was running, but there seemed to be a problem with the pipes. Problem with the pipes. Should we check the other sinks? Oh. That's, was this the bathroom? Oh. Yeah, it didn't look like the bathroom from there. Oops. We can't try this one. Same. Palm of the pipes. Should we check all the sinks? There's some more bathrooms to check. Well, that we can check. I'm trying to remember. I don't think there's any other sinks down here. There's a library, dining room, that foyer entrance room type thing, yeah, the stairs, the sitting room or whatever, den. All the other sinks would be upstairs in those two bathrooms. Or one bathroom. I think it's just one bathroom? Here we have the gallery, the two bedrooms. Well, that's odd. If you want to use the bathroom, you'd have to go upstairs to this bathroom or use the maid's bathroom. There's no bathroom. So what's in here again? Oh no, you use this bathroom. Forgot about this bathroom. Problem with the pipes. It's gonna be the same everywhere. Can we go close to the tub? Check out that. I mean, maybe along the way it's working. We can't look at this one. And, we can clear out the pipes though. Just an idea. And then there's the other bathroom up here. I can't just aim at the stairs and just go up there. Is there even a sink here? I mean, I didn't finish making this room. No. It doesn't have a sink. Just a toilet that's not even probably connected. Okay. And then there's the attic tower, which doesn't have anything like that. Those two rooms. Let's try going back out to the greenhouse then. Maybe we had to just discover something's wrong with the pipes first. Maybe I'll figure it. Maybe he's written something. Nope. Anything new. It's so dark until you go down there. Spend more time opening and closing these doors. Just trying to get the water running is a huge task. I think that's the way we had it. Just trying random stuff now. We can take that now. So now the water will run, maybe? It was the shovel that I had taken from the greenhouse. I got it. So now the water level will rise and the thing will... There's no way I could reach it. What? It disappeared before my eyes. The shiny object had been washed away. I wondered where. Well... Maybe back in that pond by the tree? So it didn't float up, it floated away. Now, the only thing I keep forgetting is where we go to get the tree. Where we go to the tree. I think it's this. Whoops. What do we have? A key! I had been through a lot to get that small key. My efforts have been fruitful. I have managed to retrieve a key that was lost in the greenhouse, although it seems to me like someone lost it on purpose. I wonder what it will open. Wasn't there this one desk drawer that wouldn't open? My problem is I don't remember where. I don't think for sure. We know what's inside the house. No desks here. Fireplace still crackling away over here. Let's take a look at it. Indeed, burning nicely. Oh, was it in the library? I have a feeling it was down here somewhere. When I was wandering around off screen, I was trying to use a key to get into somewhere, like, before the beginning of the last episode. I spent like a half hour just wandering around this place. Figured I'd cut it out just to save you guys immense boredom. Right, that was locked, and I had tried other keys. Of course, I wasn't successful. So I didn't put that on screen because nothing else was working. The house key, of course, we had used before. So perhaps this key goes in there. It looks small, like it would fit, you know, something small. Ta-da! Look at that. We got money. We're not interested in that. We got a box and we got letters. Let's read the letters. March 21st, 1963. Dear Catherine, first of all, I beg you to take the utmost care in order to keep this letter away from James. I don't like to think of the mental breakdown he would suffer if he reads this. And I was timing and I stopped. Hold on. Okay. Okay. You know James much better than I do. So you must share any conviction that he'd never harm anything, but even so, I'd ask you to be careful whenever he's around, at least until we sort out the situation. He has been especially unstable lately, speaking about his determination to suppress this so-called curse. I truly fear for him and for his sanity. I still wouldn't say he qualifies as dangerous, but just in case, be cautious. Famous last words. I've been playing the role of an ally who believes in James, and so far I think I've done a good job in convincing him. I'm afraid it won't last for too much longer. I can't do all the things he's now asking me to. He has been delving into some very obscure arts, and what began as a hobby has now become a dangerous obsession. He wants me to perform an African ritual on that awful mask he brought. He's convinced he has released an ancient spirit which will harm everything he loves and cares for. I'm correcting grammar. It's also utterly insane that I'm ashamed to translate this into words. My biggest fear is that I will end up losing my own mind along with his. I have to put an end to all of this. And about that other issue, you should know I've gotten over it. Catherine, what we all did 2 years ago, the decision we made and knew it would affect the course of our lives, has been haunting my sleep ever since then. I know you must be the one more affected by this, but you wouldn't understand all that has been going through my head. The confusion, the contradiction. Now, more than ever, I'm not sure whether it was the right decision or not. But there's no turning back, and we must face the consequences. What did they do? What we all made? Not both made. Because it makes me think that they had an affair. That's 2 years ago, too. Oh, 2 years ago. With the baby. Decision we made. That was 61. Because this is 63. They made a decision to kill the baby? All I wanted to say about this is that I am deeply sorry if I behaved erratically these past days and unnerved you. You have my word I won't ever reveal anything. Whatever you do with this letter, make sure James doesn't feel anything suspicious. I'd rather have you destroy this, though. Extreme situations require extreme measures, Christopher. Huh. Numbers. Six, these don't move, as you noticed. 69841. 79841. Are these supposed to move? I don't remember seeing a letter. Well, I notice it's 4. Oh, 1. It's part of Bailey's number. 6, 5. Not of a count number, but it's 7 digits long. 6, 5, 2, 1, 7. 2. 94. This is the bank phone number. 94. Yeah. Unless it's part of the account number. 6. Doubt it. But it's something I've written down. 91. Oh. Yeah. 191. Oh. 2. No. What's this I have written down? 03211. I don't even remember what that is. Oh, that went past. Oh, 3211. No. I mean, maybe it's dates, but what if I didn't bother writing them down, but we know that the kid's name is gonna be Robin. There were numbers on the side of that, on the side of those blocks. I've been wondering why they only told us R. You know, we're supposed to figure something out here. So let's try to figure something out here. I wonder if he'll even go down in the room again. I mean, the way he talks, he almost killed himself the first time. Takes a breath here, okay. Aubin. Alright, so I'm just gonna write this down just in case that might be it. Because there is 5 letters in that name. That's kinda what tipped me off as well. 6097. So if that's true, I mean, we could try to find the R, but, well, we could brute force it. Just have everything else filled out, and then just hit the numbers until... R is 5. That could be it. I mean, why else would they let us even go back in here? I think it's a library. Study. I don't know. So many doors. 5. 6. 0. 9. 7. Come on. It's not it. Oh, crap. Okay, I went back, and I looked at my video, because I didn't feel like just climbing down the rope again, seeing if I wrote something wrong. 56097. Now, the thing is, the funny thing is, the O for Robin, the O is facing the other way. All the blocks have the numbers on the bottom left, no, sorry, the bottom right-hand corner. So you've got a block like this, and the numbers in the corner here, and then the letters, you know, front and center, of course. But the O is changed around, and the number for the O is up in the top left corner. So the O needs to be turned around. So it's 5, 9. Wait, yeah, Robin. The 6 is actually a 9. 6 is 9, baby! What the hell? Open it. Oh. What? What is this all about? Am I supposed to put something in here? Well, I have a shovel. Am I supposed to take that out? What the hell? What is that for? That made a different click, didn't it? Wait a second. Oh! Oh, just brute force this thing. All the gears, look at that. The key was heavily adorned. I don't even sure what this is for. Cause I think we've unlocked everything, haven't we? Unless there's the matter of her corpse. I kind of forgot about. Now that we have the shovel, where was it again? I didn't know where I should dig. Oh, just try anywhere. That's the only place that we can click on. Oh. Guess that's not good enough for my character. We need to know precisely where to dig. Is anything else locked? No, it's still... still that. Efforts have been fruitful, and I have managed to retrieve a key that was lost in the greenhouse. Oh, I read that. A draw in the study provided me with further revelations on the Blackwoods drama and a very tempting box. Except I need to know a code to open it. That's it. R-O-B-I-N, the name of Blackwood's dead son. The cubes in his room didn't spell out the word B-I-N, but part of this name. Bin. But did he think that at some point? And of course the letter R... I saw in the crypt came in handy. Now let's see what secrets are stored inside this box. The box contained yet another key, except that this one looks fairly important. Also, I'm wondering why exactly Blackwood used the name of his son as the code to the box. Guilt, perhaps? Oh, it is the son. He's not dead. I don't know. Anyway, I'm out of ideas for now. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.